The Sunday Baroque podcast is made possible by WSHU and the Friends of Sunday Baroque. You can find out more about the Friends of Sunday Baroque and find out how to become one yourself by visiting our website, sundaybaroque.org, under the Contact tab.
Over the course of his career, cellist Bion Tsang has received numerous awards, including an Avery Fisher Career Grant, a Grammy nomination, and a bronze medal in the International Tchaikovsky Competition, among others. The New Yorker has performed as a soloist with top orchestras across the globe and has collaborated as a chamber musician with musicians such as Yo-Yo Ma and Leon Fleischer. He cultivated his talents at Yale, Harvard, and Juilliard, and now he is inspiring the next generation as division head of strings at Butler School of Music at the University of Texas at Austin. Bion Tsang has a new recording of the 6 cello suites by Johann Sebastian Bach, played on an extraordinary instrument, and he joins me on Zoom to talk about it. Welcome.
Thank you. Hi, Suzanne.
Hi. So before we talk about your new recording, this is a challenging time in the world, and it's a pandemic. It's affected lots of people, and it's affected us all differently. How are you doing in general with, you know, quarantining, and have you been pursuing any special hobbies, or how's it been going for you?
It's been good and bad. It's been for everybody. And luckily, no one has gotten sick, so we have that to be thankful for. Teaching has been difficult, but we've managed and learned newer ways to deal and to listen and to use that to our advantage. This time has been great for my family in the sense that I've had a lot of quality family time. You know, I haven't traveled, obviously. During all of COVID, I didn't get to travel. And so my kids got to see me. I finally learned after all these years how much my kids missed me, aww, you know, wanted me at home. So that was really great. You know, and our firstborn has just left the coop and is now on his own in LA. Mm. It was very good timing in that sense. So good and bad.
Wow. So let's first talk about the cello suites by Bach. These are pretty much the holy grail for every serious cellist. Why is that? And what makes this music such catnip for cellists?
Well, there's nothing else like it. I mean, since Casals at the age of 13 discovered them in the late 19th century, and then started to perform them and recorded them, of course, they've become such an important part of our music. And since then, a number of composers like Kodai, Casado have written solo pieces, but nothing like these. We're in Britain too. The Britain suites are incredible. For example, the Britain suites, I mean, they're extremely challenging, but they're almost more, I mean, I think a musician or a player can appreciate those pieces far better than these Bach suites, which anybody can appreciate. I think what I love most about these suites is that they're almost like miniatures. I think of the compare them to this, the violin sonatas and partitas or the Brandenburg concerti. They're not huge like those pieces, which are also amazing, but can actually, I find, can be kind of tiring, you know, after a while. It's like there's so much invention going on, but it goes on for so long. It's like, you know, it's like, oh my God, you have to study these pieces for so long to really, whereas the cello suites, I mean, they're smaller and in a way it's almost like, God, he was hundreds of years ahead of himself, right? Because that's how we take in our information and entertainment these days is in short snippets. And so these, they're just timeless in that sense. Yeah. I think it's really cool that I mean, not only are the dances, but they're dances from different countries. And so it's almost like getting a tour of Europe, right? I think also what's so unique about these pieces is that, and what also makes them hard, difficult to play and to learn, is that there's literally no instruction other than the notes themselves. I mean, there's only in the sixth suite, only in the very beginning does he mark some dynamics, and that's it, in all the six suites. And so the choice is left entirely up to the performer to figure out what does he mean by these notes. I mean, what's he doing with this? And so it leaves a lot of leeway for the interpreter, you know, to decide, well, this is how I feel, you know. By the way, is one of the joys of teaching, is, you know, every time a new set of students come in, I get to hear it yet another different way. And it's like, hey, you know, I like that. Maybe I'll steal it the next time I play these.
Yeah. You touched on something that is so fascinating to me, because now you've kind of explained what I was going to ask you. So many cellists have recorded the cello suites multiple times. I mean, Janos Strucker was like five times, and Yo-Yo Ma just came out with his third recording of them. And so I guess maybe that's the key to it. What you just said is that there's just sort of so much there, and because there's nothing or very little that's specified, you really have a lot of interpretive ability. Yeah.
And you know, it's obviously a huge undertaking just to record them once. But then once you record it, it's like you want to do it all over again. And you do want to have that second and third and fourth chance to record it again. Of course, that's the beauty of live performance, right? Is that every performance is going to be different. And that's why we cherish live performance so much.
Yeah. So for your recording, you use this rarely heard 1713 Bass of Spain Stradivarius cello. It is a few years older than the Bach suites themselves.
That's right.
This is an extraordinary instrument. I have a cellist friend. He said, this is one of the greatest cellos ever. And how did you come to have this instrument to use for your recording?
Well, I've been going to the Seattle Chamber Music Festival for now the Seattle Chamber Society for 25 years now. Wow. And one of the patrons and audience members is David Fulton, who happens to love, well, he's a violinist himself, but he loves collecting string instruments. Mm-hmm. And at one point, he had, I think it was really the greatest collection of violins, violas, and cellos, and bows as well. And so I'd go over to his place and try out his instruments, and it was one of three cellos that he had. And he was generous enough to loan these out for performances in Seattle. Mm-hmm. And when I had the courage to record these suites, I asked him if I could borrow the Bass of Spain, and he said yes.
So, wow. That's a good friend to have.
It's a good friend to have.
Wow, that's extraordinary. So, you know, my producer, Julie Fridino, and I were talking before this interview, and, you know, she was saying, you know, it's just, that's one of the astonishing things about classical music is that, you know, not only the music, but in this case, the instrument is so old and yet still living and still making music and still revered. And so what's that like? I mean, not only the opportunity to use this instrument, but literally, what is it like to reach back into history in this way?
Yeah, you know, so it's interesting that you put it that way, because yeah, it's a piece of history, yet the cello is not set up the way it was set up back when it was first made. I mean, it has a modern setup with higher strings, steel strings, a Belgian bridge. I'm playing on a bow that was not made at that time. So on the one hand, yeah, this is this piece of history that is just like the Bach suite is just as good, if not better, than anything that's made today, right? But I'm playing on it in a modern setup, and I guess my approach to the suites could be considered modern as well, right? Mm. So it's kind of cool in that way, right? That you've got this instrument that was made back then, but it's now been modernized, if you will, and I'm playing these Bach suites that have been around for hundreds of years, and I'm coming about it with a modern approach. Although I do consider myself to be an old-fashioned cellist.
What does that mean?
I think that it means that there's this kind of what I don't know, might be described as the golden era of string playing, when you think about like Jascha Heifetz, Gregor Piatigorsky, mm-hmm. Pablo Casals. And it's a different stylistic approach, a different aesthetic. Mm-hmm. To string playing that just really speaks to me. So I don't know, that's how I hear myself. Mm-hmm. I'm sure by osmosis, you know, I've got Yo-Yo in me, I've got Rostropovich in me, I've got, you know, a lot more modern influences as well, but yeah. That's just the kind of style of playing that I associate with.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So in general, what makes a great cello? I know that you usually play a pretty modern instrument.
I do, yeah. What I feel makes, you know, it's different, I think, for cello versus violin, because cellists have to deal with projection all mm-hmm. the time. And usually the larger the instrument, the more difficult it is to speak. To get the strings going. So for me, what's important in the instrument is how easy it speaks. And then of course the range of color. Mm-hmm. And in the instance of the Bass of Spain, not only do you have all of that, but you have perhaps the loudest cello ever created.
Wow.
I remember at rehearsal, I think it was one of the first times I played on that barred that cello and was playing the Mendelssohn D major cello sonata with my dear colleague Anton Nell. And we were rehearsing, he was staying with this host who had a 9-foot Steinway. Mm. Huge, huge instrument, huge sound, and Anton was saying this is like a soloist, you know, instrument made for Carnegie Hall.
Yeah.
And that's that sonata is not forgiving in terms of balance. But I'm playing and I'm thinking, Anton, yeah, you could play louder.
Oh. Wow.
And you know, I just felt like he couldn't cover me. That's
wow.
That's how magnificent that cello is as far as projection. But it's got everything in. And I can't remember the story behind why it's titled the Bass of Spain. It actually doesn't have to do with the sound. It wasn't named that because of the bass in the cello. But the reality is that cello does have one of the best basses of bass sound of wow. low sounds of any cello I've ever played on.
Wow. Do you have any plans to use it again for any future recordings?
I would love to. It's unfortunately in Russia now.
Oh.
It's so hard to get to.
Oh, what happened?
Yes, Dave ended up, he sold it. Yes, he started to sell it where I think he's almost sold his entire collection now.
Oh.
Yeah.
Wow, thank goodness you got that recording made.
Exactly.
Wow. So What are your favorite movements of the Bach suites? I know that's like asking your favorite kid, but you know, but there are to be certain movements that really just feel right in your fingers and just speak to you.
I think, you know, it probably depends upon my mood, you know, because each one, speaks to you in such a different way. I've probably played the third suite the most. It's just so alive and happy and so I love playing that, especially the berets, you know, if I'm just kind of like, let's say I pick up a new instrument and I want to try it out, I might play those berets.
Sure.
But that being said, probably my most favorite movement might be the sarabande to the fifth suite.
Oh.
Because of the genius of how much he says with so little. You know, if I were to count the number of notes, I mean, there's literally like, I don't know, maybe less than 100 notes in the entire movement.
Yeah.
But it's an incredible, deep, emotional, you know, visceral response that one can get from listening and of course playing mm-hmm. that movement.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm. So do you think you will record the Bach cello suites again? Just like Starker
so.
And Yo-Yo Ma?
I hope so. Yeah. 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 You know, so one other thing that, you know, playing on that bass of Spain really was eye-opening in terms of like what an instrument can possibly do, right? And,
mm-hmm.
and so forever that will be my holy grail of what you know, I look for in an instrument. But I have to say that my modern cello that I play on, this Wayne Burak cello from 2011, it probably gives me, I feel like, I don't know, at least 95% of what that bass of Spain gave me. You know, mm-hmm. there's an ease to it, ease in playing that I feel liberated when mm-hmm. Playing on this modern instrument. That, because I have another old Italian instrument from 1746, mm-hmm. Giovanni Bianchi, that's a beautiful sound in its own way. It's much darker and maybe chocolatey compared to the bass of Spain, but it's hard to play it has to be set up just so, and there's like this one guy that I'll go to in Boston who can set it up, and when it come out of the shop from his setup, it's like, oh wow, okay, this I can work with this. But it has to be always in perfect shape. Otherwise, it loses that, you know, that elasticity and the ability to just do whatever. Whereas this Burak cello that I'm playing on, it's like, it just works. Yeah. And,
yeah.
You know, if I feel like it needs something, I just put a new set of strings on and mm-hmm. boom, it's
yeah.
back to square one. It's great.
Maybe the other is like a, you know, sort of quirky classic car or whatever that doesn't get driven enough,
absolutely.
You know?
That's right. Yeah.
So you chose to record the Bach suites at the Bastyr Chapel in Seattle. How'd you pick that location? Was that in any way related to the cello's resonance and projection?
Yeah, it was done there because the cello, that's where this, the home of the cellos was at that time living in Seattle.
Right.
So that's why I found a place in Seattle.
So it's a chapel. I'm assuming it's a fairly small space.
Yeah, it's like a medium sized space.
Mm-hmm.
Probably thinking off the top of my head, maybe a 200 by 75 feet wide, 200 feet long, but very tall, maybe 40 feet tall. Pretty nice space. The recording uses just the hall sound. There's no added reverb.
Oh, beautiful, yeah. Beautiful. That's really, as you were saying earlier, the considerations for when you're recording are really different than when you're trying to play in a big hall concert hall, if you've got an instrument like that, you really want to let it do all the talking. Well, I have been speaking with cellist Bion Tsang, who recorded Johann Sebastian Bach's cello suites on the Bass of Spain cello, Stradivarius instrument. Thank you very much for making time.
Oh, my pleasure. My pleasure. ¶¶